Hi, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and this is all about fertility in men. So this is my top 9 in 9 tips and health hacks for helping with male fertility. Tip number one is detoxification of the body. So whenever I saw my patients who were trying to get pregnant, I always encourage both the man and the woman to detoxify, getting rid of those internal toxins in the major organs of excretion, like the liver, the kidneys, the lungs, even the skin, and making sure that they were doing it in a healthy and a natural way. What happens is that when that toxicity builds up, then all of our organ system and the functioning, especially of our urogenital system, decreases and lacks in that energy. So important to detoxify. I usually recommend that you're detoxifying at least 4 times a year at the change of seasons, but specifically if you're trying to get pregnant, that both man and woman are doing this at least 3 months leading up to conception. Tip number two is exercise. So studies have shown that exercise helps to increase testosterone levels. So I have one of those studies here. Now, you don't want to do too much exercise because the research has shown that too much high intensity exercise can actually decrease testosterone levels. So you want to be at a moderate level of exercise. And it has shown that long-term exercising helps to increase testosterone levels. So that's really important to know. Tip number three is one of my favorite herbal medicines, and this is maca. So in the research, it has been found that maca is really helpful for serum hormone levels in men and women. And the great thing is that it actually increases the sperm count. Also, this is what I found was one of the first double-blind randomized placebo-controlled pilot trials in which the semen parameters and the hormone levels in healthy adult men were improved by taking maca. So that's incredible. Also, the sperm concentration and motility improved with taking the maca. So that's really important to know. One of my favorite herbs for men's formulations. Now, tip number four is to decrease your stress. So stress we know is not helpful for a healthy body, but specifically when relating this to fertility, it's important to decrease the stress. So one of the great herbal medicines for stress is called ashwaganda. Now studies have shown that ashwaganda, which is known as withania somnifera, helps in oligospermic males. So what that means is low sperm count helps to increase the sperm count by 167%. Yes, as well as increasing the semen volume by 53%. And this study also showed that there was a 57% increase in sperm motility. So fantastic in that ashwagandha for decreasing that stress, but also increasing specifically the viability of the sperm. Tip number five is to eliminate some of the bad organisms that can be in the system, and especially in the male urogenital system, there can be some bad bugs. So it could be candida, it could be parasites, it could be bad bacteria, and it's important to kill these off. So much like detoxification, as a naturopath, I often talk about cleansing out those bad organisms and doing parasitic types of cleanses, but doing them naturally. So one of my favorite herbs here is called black walnut, and the black walnut is known to kill off intestinal worms and parasites, but is helpful for clearing up candida as well. Tip number six is on the mental sphere. So when we're talking about the mind-body connection with fertility, I ask you, was there a time in, or do you continue to feel demasculinized? And what I mean by that is, when was your masculinity threatened? Or whether it was, or you perceived it to be threatened, it doesn't make any difference. That negative emotion and that negative impact on your mental capacity and your mental thoughts can have a negative effect on your fertility. So one great thing that you can do is a positive affirmation, and you say to yourself, and I love affirmations, especially if you say them to yourself in a mirror, and I want you to continue to say this to yourself, that I am strong. I am a strong male. I am strong. And the more that you do that, the more you actually believe that about yourself, it will really go to great lengths for helping with your sperm motility, but also the numbers, but also for your overall fertility as a man. Tip number 7 is zinc. Now, zinc is an important mineral for decreasing the bad testosterone, the DHT, the dihydrotestosterone, which is linked to, you know, male diseases in the reproductive organs and in the prostate, and also causes the gynecomastia, so the development of breasts in men as they age, as well as losing hair and the receding hairline in men, so, and some weight gain as well. So that DHT is what has that negative impact, and you can help to decrease its production by consuming zinc. Now, zinc is found in some food sources, but also you can take it as a supplement. And I really like zinc bisglycinate, which is a great supplement because it's really highly absorbed. It's bound to glycine, which is really easy on the stomach as well. And be careful with your zinc supplements that there's always a little bit of copper. That copper helps to balance, because they compete for absorption, helps to balance and make sure that zinc is readily absorbed. A study has shown that zinc is an essential element, especially for male fertility, and zinc concentration is high in the seminal fluid, and that's important and has a multifaceted role in sperm's functional properties, as according to this study. So really important to know that you can take zinc in your food sources. One of the great ones is pumpkin seeds, a great whole food way to get zinc into your diet, but taking the zinc bisglycinate is a great way to ensure that you're getting enough zinc on a daily basis for your fertility. Tip number 8 is to get regular circadian rhythms. And how do you do this? Well, one tip is to make sure that you wake up with the sun and you go to bed with less and less light. So a great way to get your circadian rhythm and into sync is when you see that sun and your body perceives that sun is rising, that you're waking up with the sun and going to bed, or at least turning off your all of those blue light radiations. So whether it's your cell phone, whether it's your tablets, the TV screens, turn them off closer to bedtime so that you can allow for your hormones to now set up that proper circadian rhythm, which has a lot to do with your fertility and your overall hormonal health. Tip number 9 is the Dr. Janine truth. And what I always found with my patients that were trying to conceive is that often when there was difficulties with fertility, it had a lot to do with the stress that was going on in their life. And I would always tell my patients with great success that, you know, you really have to make room for a new baby to arrive and to come into your life and to be able to welcome that baby into your perfect life. The truth is, there's never a perfect time to have a baby, and I know it can be. I mean, I've done it 4 times. We have 5 children altogether. Having children, there's never a perfect time, but you have to allow and create that space for that baby to come into your life to really help with opening up that energetic space for you as well. And letting go of some of the stresses of your day-to-day life is really helpful in creating that new loved one coming into your relationship and coming into your life. I'm Dr. Janine. Thanks for joining me with these top 9 in 9 health hacks and tips for your male fertility.